to see you guys. I know it's been a little minute, but I am here because people were begging me to do a Lion King review. But none of you hoes sent me any money to go watch the movie. Always the wrong way. Shut up. But it's okay, I spent my own coins in. Cause I was really dreading on seeing Lion King. Like, I won't say dreading, but I wasn't like, it wasn't like on my list. And I don't know if it's because I spent so much effort on Child's Play and trying to get that damn doll and literally promoting for them for free and I didn't win that doll. So that discouraged me from getting excited about any movie. But also, I just, even from the previews and the trailers, like I kind of been saying like, I know it's live action, which is the point is to look real. I just felt like it looked a little too much like Animal Planet.
Animal Planet's lion and Disney's lion. I mean, can you really tell the difference?
So I was like, I don't know. And then I was hearing all these mixed things, but you know, everybody has their own opinion and what they think is good and what they think is not good. So sometimes it's good to go for yourself. Oh, and also this look is inspired by a Lion King look. And it's basically, I wanted to do the eyeshadow that's, you know, the part that's around Rafiki's nose area, whatever that's called. For all my smart people, what is that called around here? But little side-by-side picture. So yeah, so basically just wanted to do eyeshadow based off of that instead of turning to a complete monkey, because y'all know I can. Act the fool. And I also made my skin tone, like even though my skin tone is close to this, but I made it a little darker. And I just did it because I'm just like, because if Beyonce can act like she likes brown skin, dark skin girls and make money off of it, why can't I? JK, but no, that was a joke. But with that being said, I do want to say this, girl. Now, I know we have our Beyonce fans. I love her too, I think she's super talented. But why did it take for Beyonce to say brown skin is beautiful for all these brown skin people to be like, I am beautiful? Did y'all really need light skin Beyonce to tell y'all that to validate your beauty? What about Indy Y'all Reed that have brown skin and all those songs before Beyonce? Brown skin, you know I love your brown skin. Not the average girl from the video. I'm just saying, you were beautiful before Beyonce made that song. And you're going to continue to be beautiful. You don't need somebody to validate that and make you feel special. You should have already known that. And if you don't know, now you know.
And if you don't know, now you know, nigga.
I can feel a B now, bitch. Bow down, bitches. Where do we even begin? Like, I took a few notes, and first off, I am going to say, I give Lion King maybe a 6.5 to a 7. I don't know. It's not like it's a horrible movie, because I mean, literally, it's like tick for tack. It's just, because people were saying that they felt it lacked soul. And I'm like, what do you mean? And when I watched it, that's how I felt. It felt like a empty shell. Like, it felt like it was a movie, but nothing there, just the movie. Like, they just did it just to do it and to show off, like, CGI. That's really how I felt. I'm just being honest with y'all. Like, I found myself through the movie wanting it to be over. Like, I really could not wait for it to be over. I was like, how long is this movie? Like, I'm sorry. Like, I know a lot of people are just biased because of Beyonce. I know a lot of people are biased because of nostalgia. So you're just like, you know what? I love it. It lacked something. It lacked something. Like, where do we start? Okay. If only I could replace Coco with Mufasa on that cliff.
Long live the king.
Hello! JK, Peter. or is it? Start with the CGI. Okay, CGI is great. CGI is sickening. Parts where I thought it looked really real was that scene from Lion King, the old one, where Mufasa is teaching him how to hunt, and he's like hunting that bird, the bird Zazu, which is voiced by John Oliver, when he's, you know, sneaking after him, and it looked really real. I was like, okay, Disney, I see you. Honestly, a part where it kind of did seem more animated was the big fight between Scar and Simba. I was like, okay, it's a little cartoonish, but still good. Let's talk about Seth Rogen and Billy Eichner. I could be pronouncing that last name wrong, but if I am, sue me. Who gonna pop me, fight me? I don't know. Okay. Seth Rogen as Pumbaa and Billy as Timon. They did a good job. They did. They had the whole, they even sound like the original cast that did it in the past. Like, I really couldn't tell the difference between the voices that much, honestly. Like, I was like, okay. And they're singing, like, which honestly, this movie kind of had, even though, you know what, I'm not gonna say, I was going to say The Lion King had too much music, but it's not fair to say because the original did. So like in Hakuna Matata, they changed one of the words to like fart from like what it used to be. But besides that, the song is pretty much the same. Seth almost had me, but he ruined my part. You know, the part where, when he was a young warthog.
When he was a young warthog.
And on the original, like the person who voiced Pumbaa really gave that, when I was a young warthog. You just felt the pride. You were just like, right on, Pumbaa. You go, boy. But this time he was like, kind of like, when I was a young warthog. I was like, I mean, you cute though. I think Seth is cute, fight me. Girl. Now let's talk about the CGI of Timon and Pumbaa. Bitch, kind of a little scary. Like, I mean, like, Timon looked just like a meerkat. Like, I mean, but it was just kind of creepy. And Pumbaa, the warthog. The only thing I like about Pumbaa, bitch, was his cheekbones. Girl, I am going to take a picture of Pumbaa, bitch, to the doctor, the plastic surgeon. I used to want Maleficent cheekbones.
Don't ruin my morning.
Baby, give me Pumbaa cheekbones. But he was a little rough looking. But hey, you have to understand, it's live action. Warthogs are not that beautiful in person, let's be real. Let's move on, sweetie, to Rafiki. John Kanai as Rafiki. Good job. He sounded like and reminded me of the Rafiki from the original cartoon. I mean, he was the wisdom. He had a wise. He was wise. He had a wisdom. And now one part did scare me, bitch. The part on the original cartoon, for those of y'all who remember, because I may not be able to find the scene, but the part where he's trying to lead Simba to, you know, see his reflection and remind him that Mufasa lives in you. And they're running through the little jungle part.
Stop!
Bitch. When Simba was running and Rafiki said, bitch, why did I kind of jump though? Like,
Lord of Memorza! Damn, this is some scary shit!
I know that happens in the cartoon, but in the live action, it was just like a little scary though, like a little scary. But he did a good job. James Earl Jones, of course, I mean, hello. Honestly, secretly, publicly, and doably, in factuality, they secretly could have just dubbed the voices over the live action and nobody would have had to come to the studio, to be honest, because, I mean, like, he literally sounded just like himself. Like, just the same Mufasa's. Good job. Let's talk about young Simba, played by J.D. McCreary. Now, y'all, this is gonna sound ignorant. And it's fine. It's fine. There's not a certain way a black person or a white person should speak, but I guess because I was like, oh, they have all this black cast, I was expecting them to sound a little more, I don't know, him and Danny Glover gave me like, it could have been a white boy tease, honestly, I'm just being honest. But JD can really sing, and of course Danny Glover did a good job. I guess maybe I was expecting him to sound a little, especially when he got older, because you know, Danny Glover plays the older Simba, I was thinking he was gonna be sounding more like, hey, yo, Nyla, yo, what's going on at Pride Rock? You know, my Uncle Scar, he tried to kill me, yo. But maybe I'll think about the BET version. I don't know. But good job. I want to say, you know who's for last. Let's talk about young Nyla, voiced by, girl, Shahidi Wright Joseph. I hope I said that right, sister. Don't fight me. You're a Disney star, girl, now. You can't fight nobody, girl. But she, you know, cute. Good job. Not too many lines, but like, good job, you know, of course. Now let's talk about Chitlin El Jajor. Chiwetel Elejiore. I can't pronounce it. Girl, I'm not a mathematician. But I think he's even in the new Maleficent movie at the end. Because now you know there's other winged creatures. Maleficent isn't the only one. And at the end of the trailer, it shows a group of like winged creatures. Let me show you a little part of that.
Spent years caring for a human. Now it's time to care for your own.
I think that's him. He voices Scar in the live action. And I have to say, you know, they were like, let's bring back Jeremy Irons. Like, same thing with Will Smith and Robin Williams on Aladdin. People were just like knocking it before it even came out. Oh no, Will Smith, how could y'all? Robin Williams will never be beat. It's like, but Robin passed away, so it's not really fair to say that. You know, people just always, they hate everything. But I think this guy did a good job. I really do. Like, he really sold me a Scar. He really did. He sold me. He gave me that conniving villain. And even the times where he was trying to like sound sincere and like trying to trick Simba, you know, but he was really trying to plan something. I bought all of it. I was like, okay, evil, I feel you. Scar's look. I mean, baba laba zee, dibba laba doo. It was zama laba zam, kaba laba zee. Okay, was that my song? Like, I mean, it was okay. I mean, it was Shabba Labba Z. Like, I know that they're going for this live action and lions don't really have like black hair or orange hair or reddish hair like Mufasa and Simba or Scar with the black hair, but I kind of wish they would have like still kind of gave them those distinct hair colors, because before I even get to Beyonce, like a lot of the female lions, I can tell who was who. But to be fair, it's the same way like in the real lion world, like they all almost kind of look alike. But I just, you know, I know Nala had blue eyes, but I was kind of just like, I couldn't really tell who was who until they spoke. And speaking of the female lion, let's speak about Alfre Woodard. I thought Alfre is always good. I mean, you know, I love her from Holiday Hearts. Always good. Not too many lines, you know, but still, like, even in the few lines she has, she delivers. Let's speak about the hyenas who were voiced by, let me get my notes, Keegan-Michael Ray, I believe, yes, Eric Andre, and Florence Kasumba. They did a good job, especially Florence. I mean, I'm doing a Disney review. Doppelganger. She killed that. I was even watching like Entertainment Tonight, you know, ET did a little like Lion King special before they premiered Beyonce's video Spirit. And it was showing like behind the scenes of them like voice acting, and like she was literally walking around JD McCreary just like, you know, they were going over their lines, and she was so into it, and she had such a very strong presence about her. She really demands the stage. Her eyes are so like, and she was just circling him around. I was like, they did that. The hyena CGI looked really good too. Let's speak about the bee, the queen of the century, mama, Beyonce. Now, I am going to say this. A lot of people were giving Beyonce a hard time. Lee Dawson. Well, not just him. Beyonce says, you were not that bad. You were not that bad. And people were saying, oh, she just sound like Beyonce. Can we be fair though? Don't most voice actors kind of sound like themselves, if we're being honest? Like, you still can hear their voice. Like, unless they're just like really, really, really good, where they can just like change their voice in different tones and pitches. But even like Robin Williams, I heard him as a genie. He still sounds like Robin Williams. James Earl Jones sounds like himself, speaking as Mufasa. He just has a powerful voice. Beyonce, I mean, she sounded like Nala. Like, I mean, like, I personally thought her stronger suits with her voice was when she was like happy Nala. Like, you know, very happy to see Simba. I was like, okay. I thought her weaker points were probably the more dramatic lines, but it still wasn't bad. My favorite line was when she was like, Simba, you have to take your place as king. I was like, oh, I felt that. Like, oh God, hold on, bitch. One of the parts I didn't like is when Shenzi, the, you know, hyena was, like, you know, they were all grown up. They were out there. Before the big old fight, they were all on the cliff, and she was like, Shenzi was like, what did she say? She was like, to Nala, I've been waiting for this moment. And Beyonce is like, I have been waiting too. I'm not a cub anymore. I was like, you know what? I thought, when I saw the commercial, she was like, almost sounding like Formation on that part where she's like, lions, who's with me? At first I thought I hated it, but I kind of liked it. I thought she did a good job on that part. I don't know. Oh, I need to come back to Timon and Pumbaa. Oh, you know, I was saying how they were singing earlier. One of my favorite parts they were singing were the little In the Jungle song. Bitch. Billy. When Billy came in with that, you know, that, you know how the song go. Aheem away, aheem away, aheem away. And then Billy came in. Aweem away, 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 aweem away. I was like, oh, come on, high note. Come on, Billy. Come on, American Horror Story. Come on, you kind of cute for a white guy. Come on, I'll bend you over. Wee! My boobs are hot. Not doing a Lion King movie about Africa and flirting over a white guy. I can't. Was it Lee and somebody else was saying that Simba's face didn't really, not even Simba, but it's in general, the lions, like his face didn't really give good emotions. Like when Mufasa died and when other things happened, he had the same face. Like literally, he was smiling, but you know, because they couldn't really make his face more dramatic. I miss the more emotions of the animals' faces, because honestly, I didn't even feel sad this time for Mufasa dying. I really didn't. Like I was just like, because I was so sad before in the original movie, I was just like, okay, like I knew it was coming, but they didn't really give me any emotions to make me feel it, except for the music. I thought the middle part kind of dragged out a long time. And honestly, guys, answer this for me. At my theater, the screen, and I saw that XD, bitch, like the best one you can watch it in. The screen seemed very dark to me. And then I literally even like got out of my seat while it was still on and asked the ushers. I was like, I think something's wrong with the screen. It's dark. And they were like, no, I think it's how it's supposed to look because it's like more real. But I'm just like, I don't know. It just seemed very dark, honestly. So that kind of bothered me. When Nala and Simba sung, you know, Can You Feel the Love Tonight? but y'all were singing it and it was daytime. I'm just like, I don't know. Maybe they couldn't make it look good in the dark, but I'm just like, it's kind of backwards.
Can you feel the love tonight?
Honestly, for me, the parts that made me feel, the stronger parts for me where I was just like, this is beautiful, was honestly the beginning and the end. And that could have even been the same for the cartoon. But like in the beginning, you know, the beginning part where all the animals are coming together and just all the beautiful scenery and Mufasa and I can't think of the mom's name, her name, but we're coming to the cliff and carrying young Simba. And it was just so, that song. And then when that big drum comes in, doom, it's like, I was getting nostalgia. I was like, I'm getting it again now. Like, I'm just like, ooh, like chills, like, ooh. Jabba 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 jiba. And then even at the end, when Simba is introducing his new son, his new, you know, heir to the throne, it was like, wow, it's like just the circle of life, how things come back around again and life keeps going. It was like, I felt those moments. But overall, sorry for the long video, you guys. Overall, The Lion King was okay to me. I still recommend to go see it, but I honestly could have waited to like DVD for me. Yeah, like I said, I give it a 6.5 to a 7. And I'm excited for It Chapter 2. Stuff like that. Y'all know they're doing another Halloween. Girl, they're doing Halloween 2020 and Halloween 21. Halloween 21 is supposed to be the end of Halloween. God damn. I'm not even gonna edit that part out because y'all know things always happen to me. But I'm like, girl, as long as Jamie Lee Curtis could be old as bat doo-doo and in a wheelchair, girl, they are still gonna make Halloween keep on going and going. Anyway, but I just had to bring that up. But thank you guys for being here. As always, stay beat, stay beautiful, and in the words of Simba and them, rah! I'm gonna just edit that part in. And stay blessed. Bye, guys. A-heem away. In the jungle, the mighty jungle, the bottom sleep tonight. Doo-doom-doom-doom-doom.